Screen TV, brought to you by TCU Financial Group. We'll help get you there.
Coach, a couple days to not just reflect on the game, but also maybe reflect on the season. What have you come up with?
Well, you know, if you look at it, like I said, I thought it was there's some good and there's some bad in the season. There's going to be in any season. Like I said, to come that close to being able to advance to the next round, that's always heartbreaking, but that's definitely a lesson that we'll be able to learn from and we'll build off of this offseason.
Is that one that's going to gnaw you for a few months, or can you just let that one go like other losses have gone?
If a loss is a loss, time to move on. I'm not one to look back. Once things have ended, they've ended. So time to look on to 2013 and build off of that. I mean, we'll look at it. I'll continue to look at it and just to see how we can get better as a team.
What about that sinking feeling in your stomach when Ron Bryant goes in for the touchdown? Can you compare that to anything else in your career?
No. I mean, like I said, I've been in some tough situations, and like I said, they're all the same. There's not a thought in my mind that day or even up to that second that we wouldn't win the game. And, you know, there's still a glimpse of hope at the end, but it didn't happen. And it was one of those things like, all right, you know, it hurt. It definitely hurt. But 5-10 minutes later, I was thinking about 2013 on how we're going to get better as a team.
What do you look forward to in 2013?
Well, the biggest thing is, you know, there's always going to be changes. That's the way football is. But what I'm looking forward to is, like I told the guys that when they came in here last year, I use Corey Sheets, for example. I said he had no clue what to expect from the CFL, and I thought he did a hell of a job as a first-year player. He won't be a first-year player. I have a lot of second-year players on the roster, and I expect more veteran leadership from those guys.
Evaluate an 8-win season.
Well, you know, if you look at an 8-win season, I think if it was an 8 where we stretched to get 8, then, you know, I'd be more disappointed. But I think we're on an 8-win season that could have easily been 11 wins right now. So that's the positive that, you know, whether it's the last minute letdowns or whether the 19 seconds, you know, that a loss is a loss. But you also have to say we were that close to a win. And I think that's where we're headed.
Corey, some will say that in an 8-win season there's more negatives than positives, but I'm guessing that's something that you don't feel.
No, I mean, because some will look at it the other way and just talk about, you know, the two games that we let go. There's both negatives and positives and everything, but we're not going to build off the negatives. We're going to build off the positives and learn from the negatives.
Is there a wish list for 2013 in positions? If you look at the roster and say, this is where I'd like to throw this whole year.
No, you know, right now, this point right here, you know, is still wrapping up. You know, we'll go through it. Like I said, we were aggressive last year in some things that we did. When we look at the roster, you know, the biggest thing for me is always production. And we'll look at production, and there's not an overall number that says that a guy did or did not produce. We just have to look at all positions to make sure the production is there and that guys were going up, not back.
Do you need more playmakers on defense?
You know, we ended up with the number 2 defense in the league. So, you know, we just have to have a better team. We got to do a better team, and we got to learn how to play together all the way.
You mentioned Corey Sheets. Is there any other people that stood out in your mind for their strong play?
There's a lot of guys that I can go through. But like I said, the biggest one to me was Sheets just because of how far he came from the Florida minicamp. You know, and there's a lot of guys that did some good things even from the Florida minicamp. But for him to come in and really play at all-star level was the biggest thing.
The curve of a rookie head coach, was it a steep curve for you or not?
No, like I said, I think easily I could have had an 11-win season. I think that's with ease. But, you know, at the same time, a rookie head coach with a lot of rookie players and a lot of new guys, sometimes you end up where we are. But I fully expect us to be a better team with, you know, I have 2 months to prepare before, you know, anything, whereas last year I didn't have that time.
How much better is Corey Chamblin, a sophomore coach, going to be than what Corey Chamblin, the rookie head coach, was?
Well, I think there'll be more football wisdom there, you know, and what to expect. Like I said, whether it's throwing the challenge flag or whether, you know, accepting or declining a penalty, those are things that I've done before. And I think the one thing that I've always lived off of is to make sure that I don't make the same mistake twice. And so I'll go back through and I'll comb through the whole season and see where we can improve as a team and I can improve as a head coach.
What intangibles will make the difference between 8 wins and 11 wins next year?
The biggest thing is the second-year players. You know, you have more veterans. Like I said, guys didn't fully understand what the CFL is. Like at one point you had to teach them that the last 3 minutes is a whole nother football game. Guys understand that now. They know that. You know, like I said, we'll have some more rookies in here, but I'm pleased to see how some of the guys grew. And like I said, you know, sometimes we dug ourselves in a hole, but the other thing is we were also able to dig ourselves out of a hole. We just got to make sure that we don't put ourselves in it.
What do you expect will happen with Odell Willis? You know, he hasn't been signed or anything. He's talked about 2013. He'll be back.
back? You know what? There's a chance Odell can be back. Odell's a good football player, and you know, it's his career and his choice to make. You know, of course, we want him back, but it's his choice to make.
So when you talk about you want smarter football players after the game in Calgary, is that discipline or is that assignment?
Both, and I think that's what happens when you go into the second year. Discipline is something that, you know, guys have to continue to work on. But when you say smarter assignments is, like I talked to guys about off-season and preparing with the football mind. Like I said, some guys, their preparation was learning on the fly. I just use Sheets once again. Everything he saw was new all year. You know, it was nothing, anything that, hey, I hadn't seen this before. Playoffs was new to him. And whether it's Taj and a couple of those guys, those are things that they can build off of and in the offseason they can learn from. And, you know, if you look at the teams that had the didn't have the streaks and all those things, they were veteran teams. And I think next year we would be considered a veteran team because we have guys that have more than 1 year experience.